Hello everyone, I am Gyan and you are learning computer science with Python for class 11th. In this video, we are going to write a program to calculate factorial of a positive number. So, write a program to create factorial of a positive number. Before we go to the solution, first let's see what do you mean by factorial. Factorial of 4 is multiplication of various numbers from 1 up to 4. 1 into 2 into 3 into 4. Similarly, factorial of 7 is multiplication of various numbers from 1 up to 7. 4 into 5 into 6 into 7. So we can say that factorial of any number x is equal to multiplication of all the numbers from 1 up to x. From 1 up to x. This is the general definition of factorial of any number. So let's write a Python program to calculate factorial of a number. So first let's take an input. Suppose that I want to calculate factorial of the number x. X is equal to int, of course. Then inside the int you have to write input. Hopefully you understand all these concepts. We already have talked about these concepts a lot. Enter a positive number whose factorial you want. Enter a positive number whose factorial you want. Now let's create another variable which is going to hold the factorial of x and initialize it with the value 0. Later, the fact variable will hold the factorial of x. Now, let's check the nature of x, because even if you have told that please enter a positive number, but user of your program, user of your Python code may enter a negative number. So, how your Python code will respond? Even if you told that please enter a positive number, but the user who is using your program, who is executing your program, may enter a negative number. So how your program will behave if an user inputs a negative number? That you should handle. So right here, if x is less than 0, then you print entered number is not positive. Entered number is not positive. But if the entered number is positive, then you are going to do something else. Let's not use here else. Let's use here elif. Elif. X is equal to 0. How you are going to handle it if x is equal to 0? In that case, your variable fact will be 1. As you know, the factorial of 0 is 1. That's how the value of fact will be 1 in this case. Else, inside else, your x is not less than 0 and your x is not equal to 0. Okay, because for the less than 0, this condition will execute, and for equal to 0, this condition will execute. Here inside the else body, your x is always going to be a positive number. Got it? Suppose that someone has entered value of x as 5. Then you have to multiply the numbers from 1 up to 5. Okay, this is the factorial. So if someone has entered the value of x as 5, what we can do is, we can start from 5, go up to 1, and keep multiplying all those numbers. Let me write here, then you will more understand my words. So I'm going to write, while x is greater than or equal to 1. If x is greater than or equal to 1, I did a mistake here. Here I should write fact is equal to 1, not 0, because we have to multiply the various numbers. Okay. So I should write fact is equal to 1 here. Now coming to the condition, while x is greater than equal to 1, That means what? If someone has entered the value of x as 5, then you must keep on executing the while loop until you find the value of x reduced to 1. Okay. So that many time you need to execute this while loop. Now right here, fact is equal to fact multiplied by x. Suppose that the x was 5, then for the first time we are going to multiply x with 5 and store the multiplication in the variable fact itself. After that, just decrease the value of x by 1. So what will happen here is, you keep on multiplying the fact with various values of x. Initially, if the value of x was 5, then 5 is proven to be greater than equal to 1. And here, you multiply fact is equal to 5 into 1. Then x got reduced to 4. 4 is again greater than equal to 1. Then you multiply fact is equal to 5 into 4. That means fact is 20. Then you reduce the value of x as 3. And again you check if 3 is greater than equal to 1 or not. If it is so, then you multiply the current value of fact, which is 20, by 3, and you get 60. Then you decrease the value of x to 2, and you check if 2 is greater than equal to 1 or not. Yes, it is there. So you multiply the value of fact, that is 60, multiplied by 2, that is 120. Then you decrease the value of x to 1, and you check if 1 is greater than equal to 1 or not. Yes, it is there. Then you multiply fact is equal to fact into 1, and here the next value of x will be 0. Since x is 0, so this condition does not satisfy it, and your while loop comes to an end. After finishing everything, you just have to print the answer. The answer is print factorial of x is fact. Factorial of x is fact. But there is an issue. We are changing the value of x. And since we are changing the value of x, at the end of the loop, our x is actually decreased to 0. Okay. If you want to preserve the value of x, let me store the value of x into another variable y. Why I'm preserving it? Because later, here in the while loop, we are going to change the value of x. So after execution of this loop, we are not going to find the actual value of x here. It will be reduced to 0. That's why preserve the value of x in y before we decrease it to 0, and then write here y. So the factorial of y is fact now. Save it, run module, and enter a positive number whose factorial you want. Let me write here 5. Factorial of 5 is 120. Let's try some more test cases. See, different inputs on which you check if your program is executing perfect or not, those inputs are called test cases. Okay, test cases should be designed smartly so that it checks all the aspects of your program. Now let's check how this program behaves if I am writing a negative number instead of a positive number. It says entered number is not positive, and it is also printing factorial of minus 5 is 1. Why is this print? Because the answer has been written outside of else. That's why even if x is less than 0, this print has to execute anyhow. Okay, so y was 5, fact was 1, which was not changed because this while was not executed for x is equal to minus 5. Therefore, the value of fact was still 1, and that's what it is printing here. Value of minus 5 is 1. So if you want this print statement to not execute when the value of x is negative, then put this print statement inside another if condition. So you want to print this statement only if y is greater than or equal to 0. Otherwise, you do not want to print this statement. Just perfect its indentation, and I think now you are done. Again execute it and see our program is behaving correctly or not. Minus 5. Okay, it just says entered number is not positive and the program comes to an end. This is what we expected from our program. Now let's try some other inputs. Take the input as 1 and let's see how it behaves. It says that factorial of 1 is 1. That is a good behavior. Then write 0. It says that factorial of 0 is 1. Again, this is a good behavior. Now let's input a big number and see how it behaves. Let's write the number 100. Press enter and it says that factorial of 100 is this number. So this is how you are able to calculate factorial of a number by using a Python program. Hopefully you got the logic of this Python program and you are able to create such programs by yourself. Programming is all about learning to think. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. See you in the next video.